Welcome to another episode of the E-Academy. Today we will show you how to establish a connection between the control panel and the SATEL server via GPRS. And then we will discuss how you can remotely operate the PERFECTA-based alarm system from the PERFECTA Control mobile application. We will present you in detail how to configure the application and log in remotely to the control panel. We will explain how to arm and disarm partitions and check the status of zones, and also how to easily control devices connected to the outputs of the PERFECTA control panel. Then we will demonstrate how to view troubles and other events in the system. Additionally, we will present configuration of push notifications to keep you informed about what is happening in your alarm system. Finally, we will show you how to establish remote communication between your computer running the PERFECTA software program and the control panel. In this episode, we will use a PC computer with Windows operating system, a complete configured set consisting of the PERFECTA 32 WRL control panel with pre-installed SIM card, a PRF LCD keypad, a USB RS converter to connect the control panel to the computer, the PERFECTA Soft program available for download on our website, and the SPW220 indoor siren, whose optical signaling will be used to indicate status when controlling the outputs. Today, we will also use an Android smartphone with the PERFECTA Control application installed. PERFECTA Control is a free application. For the Android system, you can download it from the Play Store. And for the iOS devices, the app is available for download from the App Store. Now, the control panel is configured and connected to the computer. So, let's get to the PERFECTA Soft program. You can see the configuration window of the control panel GSM telephone on the screen. To be able to use the GPRS communication needed, for example, to connect the PERFECTA control panel app, we must enter some settings here. Important information: the GPRS communication settings are configured individually for each GSM network operator. We have prepared a table that contains a set of data for several operators in Poland. If you do not know the address of your operator's DNS server, you can use the addresses provided by Google. We'll show you how to do it. The table in PDF format will be available for download under the video. In the settings of the GSM phone, enter the configuration data of your SIM card operator. Use the Google DNS address. Then, go to the Functions tab and select the Communication menu. Highlight the first two options on the SATEL server list. The first one is responsible for the connection to the mobile application, while the other allows the use of push notifications. The last option applies to the PERFECTA Soft remote connection to the control panel. We'll go back to it a bit later. Then, you send data to the control panel. To verify that the control panel is connected to the SATEL server, click the magnifying glass symbol next to the ID field. By default, this field displays a string of F letters. After the connection is established, the control panel will receive a unique identifier. This process may take a few minutes. As you can see, the identifier in the ID field has changed. The connection has been established. With the control panel thus prepared, you can establish connection with the PERFECTA Control application. The application has already been downloaded and installed on your smartphone. You can run it now. The first time you run the application, you will be asked for a password to protect it. Such additional protection is voluntary and depends entirely on the user. Initially, when you are using the PERFECTA Control application, tips on how it works will be displayed on the screen of the smartphone. This stage allows the user to become familiar with the program. The application starts up. First, the menu for adding a new alarm system opens. You can fill in the visible fields yourself. The IMEI number and ID number should be copied from the PERFECTA Soft program. Both numbers can be found in two places: at the bottom of the project menu or in the communication menu. To enter the data into the application, you can also scan the unique QR code generated in the PERFECTA Soft program. This is a more convenient and faster way. In addition, you can copy the graphic code and email it, for example, to users of the system so that they can configure the application on their mobile devices themselves. So let's go back to the program for a while to generate the QR code. Click on the Project tab. In the lower right corner of the expanded list, you will see the QR code icon. Click on it to generate a QR code with your system data. Under the QR code, you can find the encryption key. This number is assigned automatically, but you can change it, for example, to make it easier to remember. This key will still be needed after scanning the QR code in the PERFECTA control application. Let's go on to it now. The QR code icon appears in the top right corner. Click on it. Now you must scan the QR code from the computer screen. The application will ask for a password to the system data, that is, the key assigned in the program. As you can see, the fields for the alarm system data have been filled in automatically. Additionally, you can choose the icon that will be assigned to your system. The final step is to enter the password of the user of the given smartphone. Enter here the same password that is used by the user to operate the alarm system from the keypad. An important note, after each change of the user password, you must enter the new password in the application. If you forget to do so, the application will not connect to your system. In our example, a third change of the user password will be used. Confirm it and move on to the next step. Now you must decide whether the user is to be informed about new events in the alarm system. If you enable this option, a detailed list of event types will be displayed. Highlight the selected ones, then confirm. The list appears in the application at first only with one item that corresponds to your alarm system. This list can be supplemented by adding other items, that is, the next systems you want to control. Choose your alarm system to connect to it. Wait a few seconds. Once connection with the control panel is established, the dashboard will be displayed. You can control the partitions from here, for example, to arm and disarm them in various modes. For example, you can select the first partition and then the moon symbol denoting the night armed mode. As you can see, the first partition has been set to the night armed mode. You have also received a push notification to inform you that the armed mode has been activated. Click on the information display to expand the list of events where you will find more details. Now we return to the partition view and disarm the system. Another icon in the list is responsible for the zones. A list of pre-programmed zones with their status is displayed. Depending on permissions, the user can inhibit or isolate the selected zones. This may be useful, for example, when a building renovation crew are present in some part of the protected building. Next, you have the icon of outputs. Select it and go to the list of available outputs in the system. Some of them are programmed and controllable outputs. You can control them remotely using the PERFECTA control application. Now we will show you how to remotely start up devices connected to the system. To do this, select the status indicator at the top of the list. Then click the circle in the top right corner. This will change the output status. In our case, it will turn on optical signaling of the siren. Now turn off this output. When discussing the controllable outputs, it should be added that PERFECTA control panels allow the use of 8 programmable timers. They can be used both to turn on and off individual control outputs at specific times of the day, as well as arm or disarm selected partitions. Let's go to the next icon. Select it to open a list of current and saved troubles. In the meantime, the control panel power was turned off for a moment. This was displayed in the list of troubles. After the power is restored, the trouble information is marked as saved. If you do not need this information, you can clear the trouble memory. The last icon is related to events. Here you can view the entire list or just selected events. To do so, the filtering function can be used. In addition, by selecting the envelope icon, you can email a list of the 20 last events directly from your mobile device. This allows the user to quickly inform his or her installer, for example, of any troubles that may occur in the system. And this is the end of the presentation of the PERFECTA Control mobile app. We will also show you how to configure a remote connection between the computer running the PERFECTA Soft program and the control panel. The possibility to remotely operate the system by the installer is extremely convenient and useful, especially where the computer cannot be directly connected to the control panel. This may be useful, for example, when we want or need to react quickly to a system user request. In this case, you can immediately remotely modify settings of the user's control panel. So let's go back to the program. Go to the communication menu. In the SATEL server options, select the last field, connect to PERFECTA Soft via SATEL server. Send data to the control panel. Then open an additional menu on the right side of the screen. Select the connection option. A window will open in which you can expand the Remote Connection SATEL server list. Make sure that the ID field contains the control panel identifier. If there are only F letters there, connect to the server as we showed you a few minutes before. After selecting and confirming the remote connection option, the current local communication with computer will be terminated. The symbol of connection via TCP/IP will replace the previous displayed symbol of communication through the COM port. Click on this symbol if you want to establish a remote connection. If all the settings are correct, communication will be established, of which you will be informed by messages displayed in real time on the right-hand side of the screen. Now you only need to read data from the control panel, and you can start programming it remotely. And this is the end of the 40th Jubilee episode of eAcademy, and the end of the series dedicated to the PERFECTA control panels. We hope the information provided by us in recent weeks will help you improve all the work involved in installing and operating new control panels. Today, we would like to thank you and also inform you that this episode is the last one before the vacation. We will be back with the next episodes in September. We wish you beautiful weather and see you soon.